That was awesome.
I know. The reason that we showed you guys the example of a Porsche to illustrate good user experience design is because we want to explain that good user experience should make your users happy. It should make you happy. That's kind of the whole point. And UX design is about all of these tons of different things coming together. So if every person that made the Porsche, if anyone dropped the ball, the UX of the Porsche wouldn't be awesome. It's all these things coming together that really makes user experience design, because design is everyone's responsibility.
No, exactly. And I think one of the important things for us as developers to remember is that all the things that made that Porsche amazing can actually port it directly into the software world.
Yeah.
So let's bring it from the Porsche world into the software world. Now, when we're in the software world, as developers, we think in terms of code. So let's look at all the code that we write as something that goes in this box. And let's say that all the code contributes to what's called the user experience of a particular application. So now, if you take a little bit closer look at the chunks of code that we write, let's say that you have code that essentially puts pixels on a screen or interacts with the user in any way. This could be through audio input or audio output. Let's say that that is your UI code. Let's say the rest of the code that you write, stuff for your backend and so on, the non-visual code, that actually does not have an impact on the UI, but it does have a direct and strong impact on the UX. And that's something that we should always keep in mind.
So this is basically the difference between UI and UX. They're not synonyms, but they get thrown around a lot. So I think it's important to kind of disambiguate these two terms.
Yeah, exactly. The visual and non-visual code come together to deliver the user experience for your application, whereas the visual code almost exclusively delivers the user interface.
But the most important thing is that the overall UX should make your users feel happy.
Yeah, so think about an application that's made you happy. What has blown your mind by delivering an awesome user experience? Keep that app in mind, because we're going to be using that later on this lesson.